Hi everyone, it's Zoe from the Scratch team, also known as Zinnia. Today I wanted to show you how to make a virtual town in Scratch. By the end of this video, you'll be able to make a game like this one, where you can design your own town with your own characters in it and your own locations, where the player can walk around and talk to different characters. You can use this to make your own story or your own open world game, or really anything you want. So let's get started. So first, let's pick a character to be the main character of the project, the one that will walk around. I'll just hover over Choose a Sprite and click Choose, and you can pick any character you want. I think I'll pick Jordan. Now let's add a background. You could click this button that says Choose a Background if you want to pick one of the backgrounds that are already in Scratch, but you might want a top-down background, so a background that's viewed from above. Let me show you how to draw one of those really easily. So just hover over Choose a Background and click Paint, and here's what I'll do. I will click on the rectangle tool, and then I'll set the color to green, and then I'll drag a rectangle that fills the whole stage, and now I'll draw a path across the grass. So I'll click on the paintbrush tool, and I'll set the color to an orange color, and then decrease the saturation slider, so that makes it like a faded orange or a brown, and then I will set the paintbrush size to something really big, like 100, and then I'll just scribble with the paintbrush, and yeah. There you go, that's a path. Okay, so now we have a really simple top-down background of a part of a town. Next, let's add a character for the player to talk to. So again, I'll just hover over Choose a Sprite and click Choose. You can pick any character that you want to be in your town. I think I'll pick the unicorn. Let's make it so this character can talk. I'll go to the Looks category and drag out a Say block. And, you know, you can just click that to have the character say something. You can write whatever you want in here. And let's make the character talk when we click on it. So to do that, I'll go to the Events category and drag out a When This Sprite Clicked block, which is good for making something happen when you click on a sprite. So now, when I click on the unicorn, it says hello. So that's how you can add a character you can talk to. Now, let's make the player be able to walk between multiple different locations. So let's draw a couple more backgrounds for our town. So I'll hover over Choose a Backdrop and click Paint again. And now you get to think, what do you want to be here at this location in your town? I think I'll make there be a house here. So I'll make another green rectangle to be the grass. And then let me show you my extremely simple way of drawing a house. I will set the color to brown and draw a rectangle. And then I will pick a different shade of brown and draw another rectangle on top. And then pick a different brown color and make a rectangle and try to get it to line up with the bottom here. And I say that's a house. Of course, you can draw one however you want. And you know, I'll also add a lake on this background. So I'll just set the color to blue and draw a little squiggle. And let's draw one more background. So I will paint a new one and make another green square. I think for this one, I'll do three houses on a street. And if you don't want to have to draw the house again, you can click on this background. And I'm going to copy this house. To copy one shape, you could click on it and click copy, but we want to copy all three shapes. So I will click on one part and then hold down Shift. And while I'm holding down Shift, click on the other two shapes. So now I've selected them all, and I will click Copy, and then I'll go down to this background and click Paste. And now I didn't have to draw the house again. So I'll put this over here, and you know what? I will paste another house and another one. And maybe I'll make them slightly different colors, so I can just click on any part of one of the houses and change the color up here. And you know what? I will paint one road. Okay, nice. Now we have three different locations for our town. The last thing I'll do is I'm just gonna name these backgrounds so that I can know which one is which when I'm coding them. Okay, now let's make it so the character can travel between them. There's actually a really easy way to do this, so let me show you. I'll choose another sprite, and I'm gonna add this arrow sprite. And now let's make it so that when this sprite is clicked, it goes to the next backdrop. In the Looks category, there's this block, Next Backdrop, and you can click on that to go to the next background. And I will get that When This Sprite Clicked block from the Events category and put it on top. And now, if we press it, it goes to the next backdrop. And let's also add an arrow so that you can go to the previous background. I'll add another arrow sprite, and then I want it to flip directions, which you can do by going to the Costumes tab and then clicking Flip Horizontal. And now let's go back to the code tab. Now, when this sprite is clicked, we want to go to the previous backdrop. And the way to do that is, in the Looks category, you can drag out this block, Switch Backdrop To, and in the menu, you can choose Previous Backdrop. And now this block makes you go to the backdrop before. And let's add the when this sprite clicked block on top again. And there you go. Now you can click this button to go forward and this button to go backward. Here's one thing. Right now, the unicorn shows up no matter what background you go to. Let's make it so the unicorn only appears at one of the backgrounds. So it's like, that's where the unicorn is in the town. So let's say the unicorn is by the lake. So we only want the unicorn to appear if we're at the lake background. Here's how you do that. In the looks category, there are these blocks hide and show, and you can click them to make the unicorn appear or disappear. And then in the events category, there's this block when backdrop switches to. And you can use this block to make a character do something when background changes to a certain background. So, for example, I can make it so that when the backdrop switches to house and lake, the unicorn will appear. It will show up. So let's go there. Okay, yeah, now the unicorn appears when we go to the lake. And let's make it so that when we go to one of the other locations, the unicorn will hide, will disappear. So when the background switches to the path, I'll make the unicorn hide. And when the background switches to the houses and the path, I'll also make the unicorn hide. So now, if we travel between the backgrounds, the unicorn only shows up at the lake background. And so this is really helpful because now you can make a game where there are different characters at different locations and you can walk around and, you know, meet them all. Now, let's add one last thing. Let's make it so that the main character moves when you press the arrow keys so that the player really feels like they're walking around the town. I'll click on the main character so that we can add code to her. In the motion category, this block, change X by 10, will make a character move this way. If you don't already know, in Scratch, X represents how far a sprite is from this side of the screen to this side of the screen. So if you increase X by 10, if you change X by 10, the sprite will move this way. And if you change X by negative 10, the sprite will move this way because you're decreasing X. So that's how you can make a character move this way or that way. Let's make this happen when we press the right arrow key and the left arrow key. To do that, you can go to the events category, and there's this really helpful block, when space key pressed. So this block can make something happen when a player presses a certain key. So instead of space key, let's pick right arrow key, and I'll put it on top of this change X by 10 block. And so now, when I press the right arrow key, Jordan moves this way, changes X by 10. And let's make it so that when I press the left arrow key, she goes this way, so change X by negative 10. Okay, nice. And let's do the same for going up and down. So going back to the motion category, so X represents how far a sprite is from this side of the screen to that side of the screen, and Y represents how high up a sprite is. So if I change Y by 10, she goes up, and if I change Y by negative 10, she'll go down. Let's drag out a when key pressed block and choose up arrow, and make the sprite go up when I press that. And drag out a when key pressed block and choose down arrow and make the sprite go down when I click that. So now the character can move around with the arrow keys. So yeah, that's how you can make your own virtual town. You can have as many characters as you want or backgrounds as you want. Also, the link to this starter project is in the description below. So if you want to, you can always remix that. I hope you have fun making virtual towns. I can't wait to see them. I'll see you next time. And scratch on.